Today's topic, hydrocephalus. Hydrocephalus is the buildup of fluid in the cavities, ventricles, deep within the brain. The excess fluid increases the size of the ventricles and puts pressure on the brain. Cerebrospinal fluid normally flows through the ventricles and bathes the brain and spinal column. But the pressure of too much cerebrospinal fluid associated with hydrocephalus can damage brain tissues and cause a range of impairments in brain function. Hydrocephalus can happen at any age, but it occurs more frequently among infants and adults 60 and over. Surgical treatment for hydrocephalus can restore and maintain normal cerebrospinal fluid levels in the brain. Many different therapies are often required to manage symptoms or functional impairments resulting from hydrocephalus. The signs and symptoms of hydrocephalus vary somewhat by age of onset. Infants. Common signs and symptoms of hydrocephalus in infants include changes in the head, an unusually large head, a rapid increase in the size of the head, a bulging or tense soft spot, fontanelle, on the top of the head. Physical signs and symptoms: vomiting, sleepiness, irritability, poor feeding, seizures, eyes fixed downward, sunsetting of the eyes, deficits in muscle tone and strength, poor responsiveness to touch, poor growth. Risk factors. In many cases, the exact event leading to hydrocephalus is unknown. However, a number of developmental or medical problems can contribute to or trigger hydrocephalus. Causes. Hydrocephalus is caused by an imbalance between how much cerebrospinal fluid is produced and how much is absorbed into the bloodstream. Cerebrospinal fluid is produced by tissues lining the ventricles of the brain. It flows through the ventricles by way of interconnecting channels. The fluid eventually flows into spaces around the brain and spinal column. It's absorbed primarily by blood vessels in tissues near the base of the brain. Cerebrospinal fluid plays an important role in brain function by keeping the brain buoyant, allowing the relatively heavy brain to float within the skull, cushioning the brain to prevent injury, removing waste products of the brain's metabolism, flowing back and forth between the brain cavity and spinal column to maintain a constant pressure within the brain, compensating for changes in blood pressure in the brain.